Thank you. Pastor One? Pastor Stephen, it's a little, still a little bit. Pastor, no, that's too much. That's too much. Keep Stephen, keep it going. Keep it. No, that's no, that's very. Jesus, it's still Steve. That's better, but it sounds a little bit scary still. Can you adjust us a little bit? Chosen one. Chosen one.
Do you have our background music?
Chosen. No. Oh, chosen one. One. Chosen one. Jesus. That's good. That sounds... Stephen, you got it then.
I think we got it.
Yeah, is that... Turn that to four. Okay. We're almost ready.
Tupac Shakur.
Tupac Shakur. Oh, okay. Okay, unmute the mic. Oh, it's on. Okay. All right. Well, let's just... let's do our quick pre-show prayer, and we'll get started. Okay. Dear Lord...
I think it's good, Richard. Seconds. Okay, dropped it, Richard. Yeah, sit in your chair. Yeah, here's your chair. No, yeah, you look fine. Thank you.
Pastor one. Pastor. Jesus. There it is. Okay. That was it's a good song choice there, Stephen. That was a good choice. Oh, I'm not quite sure. Oh, yes. Okay, hello to everyone. And welcome to the Jesus Chatline. My name is Richard Burnish, and I am your host. Hello to everybody in the room. I see Sweets 393. There's numbers there. It's moving very fast. Yeah, I need better. Hello to Crazy Mutt. I'm not sure about that one. One click, one. Okay. Anton R. I wonder if that stands for Anton Richard. we have Billy Joel. Oh, it's Book of Joel. Well, thank you. Thank you for welcoming us back. Me, Stephen, and Ivan, we've been very busy. Should we tell them what we've been busy doing, or should we leave that till a little later, Stephen?
We just let them know we have a big announcement coming later in the show.
Okay.
Well,
you could tell them. You're excited. Okay. We have a big announcement for everybody tonight. Some great news. Some great, fantastic news, really. All right. So we have some, like we said earlier, we have some fantastic news that we're going to be letting everybody in on soon. But we've been very busy, and that's why we haven't been on the past little bit. Tonight, we're going to be taking calls. Just like usual, we're here to help you out with some of your religious struggles, perhaps, or a story you'd like to share with the room. So the phone lines are open, and Stephen, are you screening them?
I'm screening all the calls.
Okay, so all the calls are screened. So we're just going to... Did you get this one? Okay. Hello?
Hello?
Hello, caller. You're live with Richard Burnish. Did you have a question? Okay, Stephen, can you hang up?
That's a joke call.
Hang up. Stephen, hang up. Okay, sorry, everybody. That wasn't a real call. That was a joke caller. I'd like to apologize for the foul language on that last call. Hello, caller. How may I help you in your quest?
I'm very concerned about how I'll be saved. I purchased the neon Bible.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
Well, my brother Joel says, I think he's in the room there, but my brother Joel told me that drinkers all go to hell. Is this true?
I can make this plain and simple for you. Drinkers go to hell. Plain and simple. Yeah.
So, does drinkers mean like alcoholics or people that just like drink alcohol?
If you have ever had a sip of alcohol, right, Stephen? Like even one, then you are going to hell. Yes.
We're having audio problems apparently.
Is there any way for me to like get the full extent of hell? I'm sorry.
Are you a drinker, caller?
I'm. Yes.
They're saying they can hear the caller. Just a
even though I bought the neon Bible, I drank some, and I'm very, very sorry. And I didn't know that drinking would condemn me to hell forever, even though it was just one beer, and I'm very sorry.
Okay. Well, how much would you say you have sin, you've sinned in? Like, how much drinking are we talking about? Is this like an occasional, perhaps, taste of wine, or is this a more serious issue?
It wouldn't be a more serious issue. I mean, I hold down a job very well, and I go to church sometimes, and mm-hmm. you know, I pray, but whatnot. But I don't think it interferes with my daily life. But I think it might be to the point where it may not. You know, if I drink anymore, it might not be good. And I think I'll go to hell if I drink anymore. So. What can we do?
Well, the first one would be to stop drinking. You've already taken the first steps in purchasing the Neon Bible. The good thing about that is that I don't know if you read the certificate that came with it, but it comes in.
No, I didn't.
Okay, well, it's on the very back, right after page 344. On page 345, okay. There is the certificate there that gets you 100% guarantee into the circle of light, into heaven, just because you purchased the Bible. So I wouldn't worry about your drinking too much, because as long as you don't start drinking again, like if you have another drink, you will have to purchase another Bible. You see what I'm saying?
Saying that every time that I drink, I need to purchase another neon Bible?
Yes, because that guarantee into heaven would be nulled. It would be like it would not be valid. Like if you were to present that at the gates, they wouldn't let you in. No.
Okay. Can you pray with me, Brother Burnish?
Sure. Certainly. Would you like to lead the prayer? Or
no. Please, you lead the prayer. Okay. I have my hand on the monitor already.
Okay. Dear Lord, I come
Dear
to
Lord.
You. I come to you in my time of need, in my time of weakness.
I come to you in my time of need. Oh, my monitor just fell
okay.
over. It's broke. It's broke. What does this mean, Brother British?
Oh, dear, that is, did it move on its own, or did you push
it? It moved on its own, and it's on the ground. No, it's not working. Okay. I have another monitor. Would that be okay?
Well, is it
if I got another monitor?
Is it a CRT or LCD monitor?
It's an LCD monitor, and it's broken.
Oh. Okay, well, yeah, get your other monitor, hook it up, and then call us back, and we can finish this prayer.
Right.
Steven, he said it moved on its own.
I've heard
that happening. Like I have a lot of I often say that I have a lot of power, but I really do.
If I had a nickel for every time it moved on its own.
I swear I don't know my it's really good. I feel it tonight, Stephen. I really do. Hello caller. Did you have
Hello, Brother Burnish.
Did you need help with something, or did you have a
story? Actually, I did. I'd like to offer a rebuttal to your previous statement with the caller in regards to the consumption of alcoholic beverages.
Yes.
Well, it clearly states in the Bible that Jesus himself consumed the devil's juice.
That's not true.
It is true, sir. I suggest you check it out. He turned water into wine, sir.
I don't believe that is true. He may have turned it into wine, but it does not say that he drank the wine, or did he encourage others to drink to drink wine. That's sin. That's you drink wine, drinkers go to hell, okay? Plain and simple. So that's it. That's the last word on that one, I would say. Hello, caller. You're live on the air with Richard Burnish.
I have a question.
Okay.
If you suck a dick, so this is like a wall of LS.
Okay, Steven, can you hang up on this one? This is that same caller from the other night. That's that. That wasn't a real call. That was a joke. I'm sorry, everybody, for that language on there. Hello, caller. You're live on the air with Richard Burnish.
Yeah, this is Barbie.
Okay, Barbie.
I have a question.
Just like the doll?
yeah, just like the doll.
Yeah.
That's funny. Okay, I have a question about sex in regards to the whole Christianity.
Oh, male. Oh, I'm just kidding. Go on.
Can you, like, what are the views on it? Can you do it before marriage? Or?
No, you cannot do it before marriage. Sex, love making is something that is reserved to a unionship with your lifelong partner in Christian marriage. Then and only then is it recommended that one would engage in sexual acts.
Okay, what positions are allowed? Like, are you only restricted to the missionary position, or?
I'm not an expert in this, but the missionary position I know is effective.
Mm-hmm.
That is an effective position there. I'm not familiar with a lot of the positions because religion is more.
Well,
Jesus is more what I'm into. Not
can you so do it before marriage as long as you're screaming, "Oh God"? Like, does that make it okay?
No, that actually doesn't help. That won't help. No.
Oh.
Yeah.
So only after marriage and
Christian marriage, and it cannot be same-sex marriage either.
Oh, okay. So yeah. Doggy style's out.
Well, anything
a chili
with
dog
anything,
is
anything,
out.
Anything with animals. Once again, I don't love. You know, engaging in intercourse with animals and dogs, like you said there, that is out. Yes, the horses.
Oh no, doggy style is not where you actually do it with a dog. I mean, do I need to explain to you what doggy style is? Or, I mean, you could probably Google it.
Is this a joke call, or are you seriously asking?
No, I'm serious. I was just like trying to make you more aware and educate you on.
Well, no, I'm not quite familiar with that particular style. I'm sorry. I had assumed that meant loving an animal, which is not okay. So. If that is another alternative style, mm-hmm. I don't know a lot about the different positions. Mm-hmm. This is more of a religious kind of a show. Maybe I can help you, you know, with your parents' divorce, for example, or something like that.
Okay. All right. Well, that was all I wanted to know. Thank you.
Well, thank you for sharing that information. And for all our viewers out there, we all learned something today that doggy style, as she says, does not involve animals. Thank you. Hey, Steven.
Hi.
Okay. Okay. We're moving right along here. Hello, caller. You're live on the air with Richard Burnish. How are you?
I am fine. I just want to regard to the last one about sex because I have a problem and I need some help.
Okay, go. This sounds good. Go on.
I have a problem like at night. I like to masturbate, and I need help stopping. I know it's a sin, but can you please help me stop masturbating,
well,
please?
Certainly. Something that me and Steven often practice, and when we're feeling tempted by a lot of things, whether it be women or drinking or anything, is, but more importantly, sexual sinning, is the next time you maybe feel the urge to pleasure oneself, simply think about baseball, like the sport of baseball, the American game. It really can help you, you know, drive
overcome
that
pressure.
Yeah, it can really help you overcome that pressure, because baseball is just straight out American fun, you know, just hitting balls, really.
So, but here's also another problem, because this is what I did when I was younger. Like, when I would be going to church and try to learn about God, I would think about masturbating while having the Bible open. And I know that's a big sin, but, I mean, is there any way I can just forget all that happened in the past and just start fresh new?
Well, there's only one way to do that, actually. If you go to www.jesuschatline.com and purchase the Neon Bible, it's the Bible that I have completed recently, and it comes with a 100% guarantee to get you into the circle light, to get you into heaven, or your money back. So there's two versions. Check it out at jesuschatline.com. We're really helping today, Stephen. We really are. We're going to take just a quick commercial break, and we'll be back to take some more of your calls. So just hang in there, and we'll be unveiling our big secret very soon, won't we, Stephen? Okay. Well, we will be right back after these messages.
Inspiration. Let Richard Burnish show you the way. Host of Jesus Chatline and author of the Neon Bible, Richard's goal is to rid the internet of filth. Life wasn't always easy for Richard, but through the power of our Lord, he was able to overcome the temptations of evil. Let Richard show you God's road to redemption and change your life forever.
Richard Burnish, he influenced my life in a lot of ways, you know. Made me who I am today. The path to redemption, yes.
Richard Burnish has changed my life for the positive.
I like his style. It's influential.
For stories, inspiration, song, and your phone calls, join us on our crusade. Richard Burnish.
Okay. And we're back. I know you guys are just excited to hear Stephen's great news. Maybe we can get into that. He's been very excited for today's show. So maybe I'll if you guys would like to Stephen, do you want to answer a couple? Okay, come on, get in here. Get in the seat.
Oh, I dropped it. Oh, shit.
Good evening, everybody. So I'd like to thank you all for joining us this evening. And I'd like to thank everybody who took the time over the last little while to send us some messages of encouragement and all the kind messages through email and through messages on JTV and on Skype. That's it. That's all I have to say. I'm going to hand it off to Rich. No, I'm just kidding. All right, so we're going to take some calls. We got a fun evening ahead of us. So we got big news. We got big news. We won't keep you in suspense much longer, but I'll leave it to Richard. He has a big announcement, and we have prepped a new promo video, which we've worked very hard on. We got it made for $15,000, and of course, all from the donation money. And we think you're really going to enjoy it, and it's really going to drive home what it is we're trying to do here. So we're gonna go on. We're gonna leave that for a little bit, and for now, we'll take some calls. Okay?
Can you just let them know that we don't live in our mother's basement?
No, we don't live on our mother's basements. Richard wants to make that did I make that clear, Richard?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. Why don't you accept my contact? Did you just request it? If you just requested it, it's kind of hard to do it while the show's happening. There's a lot going on, and there's only two of us. So what we usually do is, when the show's over, we will go into Skype, and then we'll add everybody. Everybody who doesn't sound like a serial killer or an abusive person, we will add you. Okay, I think that's all I have to say for now, so I'll just go right for the when you guys were in Japan, I even sent you $2,000 for all the hard work you did, but I haven't received the Neon Bible yet. Oh, okay. Well, we'll get on that. We'll get on that. Just, if you could, for now, send another 29. Sorry. Okay. Thank you. We're gonna get on with the show now. Thank you for calling the Jesus chat line. Go ahead, caller.
Yeah, hi, how are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm doing great. I love Jesus, and I love watching you guys' show. It entertains me every time I watch it.
Thank you.
Where did you get your haircut is what my first question.
Oh, have you ever heard of something called a Flowbee?
A Flowbee?
Yeah.
Is that like a tube pack?
It's a tube pack. Kind of a, I traded somebody for a Neon Bible because they sell for $29.95. And it's worked out, as you can see, I think the evidence is right on your screen. That it does quite a nice job, wouldn't you say?
Yes, you look great. I'm impressed.
Thanks. Thank you. I don't have quite the mane that Richard has, but I'm working on it.
Oh man, it's like the 90s all over again.
Yes, exactly.
Yes, I have another question. I'm kind of losing my belief in Jesus. Can you help me out?
Have you tried? Have you tried gargling with salt water?
Oh, I tried drinking the bottle of water that cures
holy
AIDS,
water.
But
I missed that one.
Go
ahead.
I tried drinking the bottle of water that cures AIDS, but it didn't work. Neither did Tupac.
Well, this bottle of water exactly how did you drink it? Like, at which speed? Because we recommend guzzling.
I opened up my butt and I put it right down my ass.
Oh.
Like directed.
Is this a joke?
It's not a real call.
I don't think it's
a real call. No, I'm serious.
No, I don't think it's a real call.
Hang up, Steven.
This is a real call.
Hang up, Steven. It's not real life.
Go ahead, caller.
Hi there. Is this Richard?
This is Steven.
Oh, okay. Steven.
Yes.
I just had a couple questions for you.
Okay.
The first one being, being a follower of the Neon Bible, would that make me also a follower of the Neon God, or am I still a follower of the normal God?
No, there is only one God, and you are, by reading and following the Neon Bible, you're well on your way to salvation.
Okay, to Neon Heaven?
Yeah, no, it's a regular color. It's kind of like a whitish. It's got a nice kind of glow to it.
Oh, okay. And a second question. As a like you said to or Steven said to or no sorry Richard said to think of baseball instead of masturbating. Mm-hmm. And would that also work with other sports?
Yes. Thinking of ice hockey, for example, will help as well.
Just thinking.
Thinking in general.
Think before you jump. Yes.
Okay, but what if your mind happens to wander to, say, more erotic thoughts?
Well, then you need to dig deeper than baseball, like golf, for example. Yeah, it's a very soothing gentleman's sport, so that's a good thing.
What about like wrestling?
It's well, no. Oh, hi, Roadhammer. No, the thing about wrestling is that it is two men oiled up grappling, and so we can't condone that. So you definitely don't want to think about that. It may very well stop your problem. But the fact that you are now thinking of two grappling men is now trouble.
Okay. All right. Well, that's good to know, I guess.
Yeah. Okay. Just yeah. Well. Thank you very much for calling in. We appreciate your call, and we hope to hear from you again soon.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. And. Okay, and we would ask everybody, just let's keep this channel between us. Let's not get all hasty and start posting it all over the internet, or else it's going to lead to our fifth flagging. Oh, that reminds me, Richard, we forgot to make our flag graphic. Remember, we were going to put four flags on the bottom of the next to the cross. Yeah, somebody said gays do not go to hell. I beg to differ. Not only that, but you say you're a giraffe lover. I think there's a couple things wrong there. But we're going to go right back to the calls. The calls. Oh, yeah? Go ahead, caller.
Hello, Brother Steven. First of all, I'd like to preface my call by reiterating what the brother two calls ago said. I do love the hair, very Sonic the Hedgehog. My question is, and I've seen this coming up quite a bit in the chat, it's in regards to the smoking of marijuana.
Mm-hmm.
What are your views on that, and what would Jesus say if one were to puff the wacky tobacco?
Well, sir, I'm going to come across as a little bit of, at the risk of sounding like a little bit of an, I almost said, a jerk, I guess we'll just say. I'm sure,
well,
I guess what I'm trying to say
watch
is, yes, you can probably predict my answer. Whenever somebody calls and says, what do you think of, and it's a vice, I usually have the same response, and this instance is no different, sir. I'm going to have to say that that it's wrong according to our Bible, and we cannot condone it.
Well, even though it is a naturally occurring herb,
it's made in a factory. It's a chemical.
It's what factory makes marijuana, sir? It grows from soil.
The Marijuana Co. Marijuana and then .co. I've seen their semis. I know that.
Okay. Well, maybe I'm just misinformed. Oh. Could you repeat that website again? Maybe I need to educate myself.
Oh, Marijuana Co. So marijuana and then co, like CO, like company. I know Roadhammer. He's a trucker. He'll verify this. He's driven rigs for them before, or the back part.
Okay. I know I'm asking for a lot here, but I'd like a prayer, if that's nothing too bad to ask.
Oh, no, that's what we're here for, caller.
Okay. Well, could you lead the prayer, please?
Okay, and what type of prayer is it that you would like to...
A prayer for just general goodwill and for the heathens to find the way of Jesus.
Okay.
I know you read this chat. It's an abomination. It's amazing. I thought this was for the love of Jesus Christ, my Lord and personal Savior. And some of the things I'm reading in here are completely disturbing.
I know.
Let's pray for those in the chat that are trying to undermine the seriousness of what's going on here.
Okay. Well, very good then. Lord, we pray, and all who want to join, put your hands on your
mouth. Hold on. Let me unzip my pants real quick.
Lord, everybody's hands on the monitors. Lord, okay. We pray for our chat room that you will cleanse it of all its filth.
Oh my God, Brother Stephen, can I just say my monitor is melting right now.
And that's good. It means the prayer is working.
I can't even touch it.
It means we pray for all the giraffe lovers and
God loves giraffes. God loves them.
Richard, did you say you had a prayer for this?
Well,
I'm going to hand the mic off to Richard because Richard's.
Oh,
just a
for
second.
B squared. Okay, B squared's coming on.
Okay, I'll just do
Brother
a quick.
Brother Bernie. Okay.
I'll just do a quick prayer for strength here. Do not look forward to what may happen tomorrow. The same everlasting Father who cares for you today will take care of you tomorrow and every day. Either He will shield you from suffering, or He will give you unfailing strength to bear it. Be at peace.
I'm
then.
Sorry. This is just so moving. Continue.
Put
please.
Aside all anxious thoughts and imaginations and say continually, the Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart has trusted in Him, and I am helped. He is not only
God
with
damn
me.
Goddamn right, Brother Burnish. Preach. Goddamn right.
Oh, that's watch the language there. He
I'm
is
sorry.
Not
I'm
only
sorry. I'm just...
He is not only with me, but He is in me. Amen.
He's in me.
Amen.
He is in me. I feel Him in me.
Yes, He is in us.
He is big.
He's in the whole chat room.
Thank you.
He's in this chat room. And remember, it says in the Neon Bible that
somebody that
wherever 94 or more of us are present, and whenever you are number one on JTV, that He is here. So remember, those are the things that we have to be on top of the social page, and that means the Lord is with us, according to our Bible. And if He's not, then we might as well just pack it in and go watch Sports Desk or something.
Somebody in the chat said gay men.
Somebody said gay men. Who said that?
Instead of amen.
Instead of amen.
It's amen, not gay men.
Okay. So at this point in time, I'm going to take one more call, but I'd just like to say really quickly, I'd like to thank our mods for this evening. And they are Crazy Mutt, Grand Jambi. Am I saying your name right? One Click 11, Randall, and Roadhammer, and Sweets is missing in action for now, I guess. But anyways, you guys are doing a great job as usual. So, you know, when we started out here, we tried to have as few rules as possible. Are we flagged, by the way, or were you just kidding? Oh, we're not. So anyways, when we started out here, we tried to have keep it as relaxed as possible, and we had no rules. But now that the chat room has kind of been heating up lately, we only ask that there's no racism, there's no spamming, unless it's for the Neon Bible, and there's also just try to be nice to each other, okay? And that's it, really. Other than that, it's pretty relaxed around here. And that's the way we like it. Right, Richard? So with that, we're going to take one more call. Then I'm going to hand things back off to Richard Burnish.
Remind everybody not to post it to 4chan.
Okay. Yes. All right. And we thank you for joining us, caller. Go ahead.
Yes, I'd like to talk about, if I may, the Jewish reaction to the Passion of the Christ film.
Okay. Are you talking about the producers?
Well, no, I mean just the film in general.
Oh, like Hollywood?
Well, the actual film, I guess the way the Jewish community, of course I can't speak for all of, you know, the Jewish community, but I believe I could accurately represent you know, a large aspect of the Jewish community's opinion about how that movie was received.
Okay.
Yes, that movie.
Oh, and I was holding up the movie. Did you ask a question, or did you just make a statement there?
Well, I'd actually like to make a statement.
Oh, yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
Well, you know, there's a feeling amongst the Jewish community that, you know, that movie did not take into account, you know, the kind of reaction that it could stir in people in certain countries where anti-Semitism is still very, very prevalent. And, you know, many Jews were concerned about that because after this movie, there were certainly many cases of people coming out of those theaters angry and, you know, actually looking for Jewish people and doing terrible things to them. I'm not talking murders, but there was certainly, you know, there was that portion of the community that identified very strongly with, you know, the way the Jews were portrayed as being the extreme antagonizers. And, you know, there was some blowback on the Jewish community in certain countries, you know, where Jews haven't been living for a very long time. So I just wanted to say that.
Yes. I agree, caller. Those are some very interesting points. And I think food for thought for all our viewers.
Well, thank you for giving me the forum to express that opinion.
Absolutely. I appreciate you calling, and call us again sometime. That was a great call. Thank you. Okay, that was great, I think. Okay, so I'd like to thank you all for your calls, and I'm going to throw it back. Oh, no, okay, I'm just going to stay with you for another couple minutes here. That really was, did anybody see when we did the viewing of that movie and we did the commentary? I mean, okay, we have a question here. Why are the Canucks getting embarrassed? Well, I don't know. They tend to kind of let off the gas, don't they? They were outscored 12-1 in the last two games. And I think we're seeing the Bruins play with that mean-spirited, well, not mean-spirited, I don't know if that's the right term, but with that Bruins fire, I guess. But we'll see what happens next time, right, when it's back in Vancouver. And yes, congratulations to for the Jets returning to the NHL. I understand everybody up there in Canada must be pretty happy. We here in Oakland, we're Sharks fans here, but we're quite happy for our Canadian neighbors, and we welcome back the Jets. Let's go to the next call.
Hey there, so my name is Leeroy Sinclair.
Leeroy, welcome back to the show. It's good to hear from you again.
Good to hear from you again. Yeah, you're not going to hang up this time.
Sir, as long as you keep the profanity to a minimum and stay respectful, then absolutely we will not hang up on you. And the same goes for everybody else.
What the fuck is profanities?
Okay, sir, I've tried to be patient with you in the past.
I call you, sir. Like, I get a question there. I'm over at my friend's place, and we're watching Lord of the Rings.
Uh-huh.
The one with the little guy there, Eddie Wood or whatever there, with the curly hair.
Oh, Elijah Wood?
Oh, whatever.
Yeah, Elijah Wood. What?
So my question is, have you seen that movie there?
You know, I'm not really a fan of that type of movie. I think I've seen part of it.
Well, when he's walking, because they got to throw the ring into the, they got to throw the ring into that eye, or the big eye, he's got to put it in there.
Yep.
So when they're going there, and they're fighting these goblins or whatever,
uh-huh,
are those goblins, is that like what hell is like? Anyways.
A little bit, yeah. It's like watching a 4-hour Lord of the Rings movie. You'll be in hell just waiting for it to end, but there is no end in sight, and that's the way I see it. I mean, I've never been there myself, and I don't intend to ever go there. But
well, let me tell you this right now. I've got some advice for you. Always giving advice is my advice now. So here's what you can do. You could suck a wet fart out of your grandma's ass and hold it in like a bong hit, you fucking faggot.
You know, in the last 30 seconds, I've just been wondering, do I even want to go on with this show when I hear such profanity? I let's just shut it down, Richard.
No one appreciates it.
What I'm going to do now, yes, I did crunch myself. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to take a break and ask the Lord for strength and for resiliency. And I'm going to hand it back to Richard. Thanks for joining us tonight, folks. Again, we have that big announcement coming up and that new video coming up very, very soon. Wouldn't you say, Richard? Do you want to do it in the next segment?
Let's just shut it down.
Let's give it one more chance, Richard. I'll screen Leeroy. I won't let Leeroy back in ever again. Leeroy Sinclair. 1204. Never mind. Okay. Thanks, guys. We're going to now turn things over to Mr. Burnish, and bless you all. Bye.
All right. Okay. I just wanted to apologize for that filthy call. Thank you for the support, everybody. It's just a select few that are trying to ruin it for everybody else. So we're not going to let that happen. We're not going to let that happen. A couple of bad eggs aren't going to ruin. Ain't nothing going to break our stride. okay, but we're going to take a quick break, and we will return very shortly after these messages. Thank you.
Richard, are you there? I've installed 5 monitors. They've all moved and they're all broken. I'm trying to CRT. And the CRT, it doesn't move. And it shows your face. It shows your face. Oh, thank God it shows your face. I was so worried that it shows that it was reaching me. But I'm about to read a Bible again because I don't want to go to hell. I don't want to be this drinker no more. And I don't want to be this anymore. I'll buy all the neon Bibles that I can, and I'll share with all everyone.
He is our Savior.
He is our Savior.
He is the author of our salvation.
Yes, I am the brother of Joel, the book of Joel, the brother of Joel.
Go and do thou likewise. He pleads, keep my commandments.
Oh, yes, I will keep the commandments, Richard Burnish, to buy neon Bibles every time that I drink.
Hope,
I will stop drinking.
Inspiration.
But if I do drink, I will buy a neon Bible so I can go to heaven.
And author of the neon Bible. Richard's goal is to rid the internet of filth. Life wasn't always easy for Richard.
Rid the internet of
through the power of our Lord, he was able to overcome the temptations of evil. Let Richard show you God's road to redemption and change your life forever.
Richard Burnish, he influenced my life in a lot of ways, you know? Made me who
Richard,
I am today, the path to redemption, yes. Richard Burnish?
Every LCD, it fell off my desk and it broke.
It's influential.
But the CRT, it did not fall off.
And your phone calls. Join us on our crusade.
Are the phone lines open? Hello? Hello? Is there a call? Caller?
Yes.
Oh, sorry about that. I guess we accidentally left the phone lines.
You have such power, Richard.
Okay. Well, did you have
every LCD I had on my desk? It just fell right off, and every one of them broke. But I had an old CRT.
I put
it on my desk.
Well,
I put it on my desk, and I prayed over it. Richard, and I prayed that you would be the one that would show up on it. And you were, Richard. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
And I'm buying the neon Bible 20 times at least because I believe that is.
Then, hallelujah! Let me be the first to welcome you into the circle of heaven. You made it. You're gonna make it.
Thank you.
Thank you. You've done a great thing, caller. You've done a great thing. You have not only donated to the great cause, which we'll be unveiling in just a moment, but you have also guaranteed your place alongside Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
And I'll tell you something else.
Whatever.
LCD monitors aren't going to be falling over when you're going to be relaxing in heaven with Jesus. I'll tell you that right now. It's all LCD up there. There's no CRT anything. There's LED screens even.
So the CRT was...
And they're high resolution.
It was a sign.
They're very high resolution. Like these LCDs are very high resolution.
So they were all a sign telling me I should buy a neon Bible so many times. I know it, Richard.
I will buy
the Bible 50 more times, and I will give to my brothers and sisters here neon Bible so that they will also buy the neon Bible.
Amen. Can I get an amen in the room? We need an amen, Stephen. Lead us in an amen.
Amen.
Oh, amen. And
let us pray, Richard. You lead me in prayer, please.
All right. Okay, here we go. Dear Lord, thank you for this wonderful, wonderful, wonderful man. Show him. Don't put
gay men.
Okay, it's aim. If you're going to type gay men, that's... So, Lord, bless this man on his journey. Welcome him into the pearly, pearly, pearly gates. To the land of LCD screens that won't fall over anymore, that will all have my face on them like he asked. While you're kicking back with Jesus, drinking Dad's cream. I love Dad's cream. I wish we had some tonight. Okay. Well, I'm going to put the calls on hold just for a minute. I think now is a good time for our big announcement. Isn't it, Stephen?
It's time for our big announcement.
Did we want to talk about it a bit, or should we just play it?
No, I think let's just
just roll the clip.
Let's just roll the clip, and then you can expand on it further.
Okay. Well, here is the big surprise. And I'll give you Dad's cream is a beverage. It's fantastic. I wish we had some of Dad's cream here. Well, I drank it like it's going out of business. It's an orange drink. I think it's kind of cream colored. It's orangey creamy. And it's got this fantastic taste. I could just suck back a whole bunch of Dad's cream. I really can. But we don't have any tonight. Otherwise, we'll show you. Maybe if we can put a link in the channel to Dad's Cream, Stephen?
Yeah.
Maybe we'll... Okay. Well, here is the big news. You're going to hear it first. Here. Big news, just like he said there, but all in uppercase letters. Stephen always does it wrong. Why do you always do it wrong? I told you uppercase letters. They can't read that. It's too small. Okay, well, sorry, I crossed my legs and I accidentally crunched myself. Okay, so here is the big news. I'm just gonna play it, Stephen. I'll give you a hint. When you purchase the Neon Bible, you may wonder, where does your money go? Well, take a look at this and let this answer your question.
God came to Richard and Stephen with a dream of a new house of worship, a house devoted to the one true word, the Neon Bible. Thus began their leap of faith. Through the generous donations of our disciples, Richard and Stephen have purchased holy ground where the Church of the Neon Bible will stand. Brick by brick, they will venture into erecting the greatest man-made structure that man has ever seen. After visiting the grandest churches in the world for inspiration, Richard has taken God's dream to a new level.
There it is, right there. We are so excited to announce the Church of the Neon Bible. We purchased the land, the Holy Land, and brick by brick, we will build the greatest man-made structure that man has ever built. Amen. 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 Let's talk about that. So, caller, what did you think? What do you think of that? Caller, what do you think of that? Okay. I'm curious to get some feedback on that. Or if they wonder, are you guys excited as we are? I hope you guys are. Hello, caller, what did you think of that? Caller?
Yes.
It's another joke. Hello, caller. What did you think of that?
That's a lie!
That's a lie? Okay, I'm not sure about any of that, but... hello, tell us your thoughts on the plans of...
How big is the church?
It's going to be 127 square feet.
127 square feet. So is it just going to be you and Steven standing there, or...
No, sorry, that was a bit of a joke. No, the church will be very large. It's actually going to be 200,000 square feet. Approximately right now, the designs, it's going to be about 25 to 35 feet tall. It's going to be marvelous. It really will be.
Are you going to have any nuns there or anything like that?
Yeah, there will be nuns. There will be priests.
What are the requirements to become a nun at your church? I'm interested.
Well, you must believe and follow the Neon Bible. That is the most important one. You must not drink.
Is Dad's cream okay? Like, can I still have it? Yeah. I mean, it's refreshing to have it in my mouth and on my tongue and going down my throat.
Dad's cream is welcome. And I would just ask to just send... an 8x10 glossy photo of yourself for consideration.
Okay, what should I be wearing in this photo?
Well, clothing is optional. You can wear.
Whoa, are you sure that's appropriate for?
Oh yes, whatever clothing you know would like to wear is totally optional. It's up. That's
well,
up
I guess
to you.
It'd be all natural to be nude. I guess that's the way God would want. No, it, right?
I didn't say anything about nude.
You clothing optional.
Oh, sorry. I meant to say the clothing that you wear, you could choose it. Like, it's you can make your own options for what you'd like to wear. Sorry.
Okay. And so no drinking, except I can have Dad's cream.
Oh, you could have as much Dad's cream as you like. We have a lot of Dad's cream down at the Church of the Neon Bible.
Does it like spew from fountains, and you can just go up and get as much Dad's cream as you want?
We buy it in large amounts. You see, so on the construction site, we have a whole lot of Dad's cream always on hand. So don't worry about that. If you enjoy Dad's cream as much as I do in my mouth, then you know you maybe being a nun for the Neon Bible is a good choice for you.
Okay. Where is it located? Is it in Oakland?
Yes, it is in Oakland.
Okay.
In Napa Valley.
I'll have to go by there. Is there an open house? Are you going to have an open house anytime?
Steven, do you know the details of that? There's going to be a bake-off. Well, no, there'll definitely be some bake-offs. But maybe we can work on that. Maybe we can do that.
Bingo, bake-offs.
Yeah, bingo.
We're right now in a little bit of a dispute with the wineries in the area.
Yeah, there are a few wineries in the area, and we're trying to get them shut down.
Okay, well, just send me like an application. As soon as I get the application, I'll send you my photo.
Yeah, and definitely tell your other female friends to send in a gloss. Make sure it's glossy though.
A gloss, okay.
Yeah,
so it's easy to wipe off. I mean, sorry, I'm sorry. Yeah. Do they have to be young and attractive, or are you preferring older women?
Well, I think we're open to all types of women. We don't discriminate. Just We ask that they are not too heavy.
Mm-hmm. If you can't fit in an 8x10?
Yeah, like, for example, if they can't fit into an 8x10, chances are, you know, we're not that, their odds aren't very good.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right.
So, and also we ask that they not drink or you know, have sex or that other stuff.
Oh.
But okay. More importantly, not too big. That's the main thing, is the bigness.
The bigness? Okay.
Yeah. So they fit into the 8x10, then it's okay.
Okay. Well, I look forward to having Dad's cream.
Like, well, thank you.
Amount of,
thank you. Well, I'll be happy. Come down and we'll have some cream for you. That's for sure. Oh, wow. Wow. Hello, caller. Are you excited about the new church?
I am personally very, very excited.
Oh, careful.
Hello?
Are you okay?
Oh, yeah. I just fell off my dinosaur.
Hello? You may have been touched. Not sure. Well, we'll take another call. I hope that last caller is okay. And then we're gonna roll that commercial one more time. I really wanna drive home our mission. Hello, caller. You're live on the air with Richard Burnish. Are you excited? Oh, I get a lot of hang-ups. Fortunate. Well, okay, we're going to don't roll the commercial.
We'll do what we want.
You know what? This is the Jesus chat line, not the giraffe lover chat line, okay? Yeah, I suggest that maybe you go to the Pakistan chat line or something else. If you want to talk about, there's giraffes in Pakistan, isn't there?
I think there is.
Yeah, that's what I meant. That wasn't, okay. I didn't want that to sound, okay. We're going to roll, here it is, one more time. Get excited, because it's going to happen. It's happening. It's happening already.
God came to Richard and Stephen with a dream of a new house of worship. A house devoted to the one true word, the Neon Bible. Thus began their leap of faith. Through the generous donations of our disciples, Richard and Stephen have purchased holy ground where the Church of the Neon Bible will stand. Brick by brick, they will venture into erecting the greatest man-made structure that man has ever seen. After visiting the grandest churches in the world for inspiration, Richard has taken God's dream to a new level.
There it is. That video cost $25,000, and it's worth every penny. So thank you very much for your donations. That's where they're all going, right there, to building that church. Your donations pay for those videos. So please go to Jesus Chatline. If somebody could link it in the chat room, that'd be great. Go to JesusChatline.com and $25,000, yeah. It looked good too, doesn't it? It really does. Stephen, it's really worth it. So thank you for Hassan. So please keep on buying those Bibles. Keep on donating money. Because when it all goes down, you guys will have been here from the beginning. All of you will be part of something so large. And a lot, Stephen and I were talking about it the other day, you know, did we want to put that in the video that God came to me with his dream? And I was okay with that. I think that that is a fair statement, you know. God came to me, came to us. Sorry, Stephen. God came to us and said, here is my dream. Build the church of the Neon Bible. So not only did we make God's dream come true, but we actually improved them and made them better. We took God's dreams to the next level. We really did. Okay, Stephen, I see a few calls coming in here. I have to go. Father Leping was sending an email earlier. He needs help cleaning the organ, so I have to help him clean his organ. So I'm just going to pass the mic off to Stephen. Okay. Hey, Stephen, here. I'm coming.
Okay. All right. Well, wasn't that a wonderful video? We're certainly very proud of it. And it's exciting to think where this is all heading. It's really something. It's really something. Who? Oh, yeah. Okay, so we're ready to take some more of your calls here. And go ahead, caller, you're on the air. Are you there? All right, let's see. I need a mouse pad. I have this Passion of the Christ DVD cover I'll use as my mouse pad. I don't think anyone will mind. Go ahead, caller. You're on the air.
Hi. I would like you to explain to me a thing like a friend of mine told me, and I'm quite confused by it, and seems to have some religious meaning. It goes something like this. In some distant forest, lightning strikes a dead tree, resulting in a forest fire. In the fire, a thorn is trapped, horribly burned, and lies in terrible agony for several days before death relieves its suffering.
Did you have a question, caller?
Yes. Sorry, can you not hear me?
Yeah, go right ahead.
Okay, my friend explained to me a story, and I don't seem to understand it.
Oh.
It is, in some distant forest, lightning strikes a dead tree, resulting in a forest fire. In the fire, a fawn is trapped, horribly burned, and lies in terrible agony for several days before its death ends its suffering. Could you simply explain that for me?
I have to be honest, caller. I'm having a bad... it's a bad signal here. I didn't make it. Were you referring to the Canucks game tonight?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, okay. What did you think of the game?
Viva La Nation.
Well, you know, this isn't a sports call-in show, so we're going to move on to our next caller. Go ahead.
Yes. Which brother am I speaking to?
This is Steven Chilton.
Brother Stephen, yes. My brother was touched. He was, I'm sure you heard him earlier because he had several LCDs that just miraculously fell to the floor.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want to thank you, Stephen, and I want to thank your brother, Richard, Richard Burnish, for opening his eyes to not being a drinker anymore. It's a miracle, and I have to thank both of you at the same time.
Oh, well, absolutely, caller. It's no problem at all.
Well, it was a problem for me for several years.
He never
gave up his drinking, you could say.
Was he abusive?
No, he was not abusive, but, you know, he did like grappling. I'm not sure if that was okay or not, but I did not like it. He liked grappling and whatnot, but...
Pardon me, caller. I did not say the F word. I did not mouth the F word. I started to form an F, but that could have been anything. It could have been the word fudge.
It's F sharp. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. So now that we've cleared that up, you go ahead, caller.
Yes. Well, I got to say that I love you, brother, and I love, you know, Richard, my brother. And, you know, he is buying my brother, I mean, my actual brother, he's buying several neon Bibles, and he keeps on saying that he will not stop buying them until the day that he dies. So I think he is a devout believer in the Richard Burnish, what have you. I think he's very excited about this church that you two are building.
Great. Great. Well, it sounds like it's done a lot of good, and you know, who knows where this can go. And let me tell you how this has worked. Richard and I, we started working on a construction site, doing a lousy job where we had to put up with a foreman with a biker mustache who drove an F-150, and he listened to classic rock. We had to listen to Leonard Skinner all day, and we had to listen to filthy sayings such as, I'm going to get up and damn you know what. Well, once we made enough money from the construction site, we purchased a good internet connection and a Macintosh computer. And from there, I've just been notified. Ladies and gentlemen, we've been flagged, our fifth flagging. Our fifth flagging now.
Shut it off.
So I'll continue with my story. So then once we had our internet connection, we gathered a following and we were able to gather donations. And then we were able to buy a red cam. And once we had our red cam and our rig, well, then we started to make videos. And once we made videos, we got even more donations. And now we're making a church. And do you think it's going to stop there? Well, hell no. I mean, we're thinking maybe like a space station down the road. But anyways, one thing at a time. We're gonna do our church, and then who knows, maybe onto a sports team. There's many ways we can spread the word. I'm just kidding about the space station. But I really do believe in the sports team. I think, don't you think, Richard? Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I think we're flagged. Someone's trying to hack us.
We should just quit.
We should.
Let's just quit.
Caller, what do you think of our latest flagging?
Hello, this is what I think. Finally, your papi 69 has called and gone in through the Jesus chat line.
Well, welcome. You sound very enthusiastic.
You know what? You know what? Your papi 69 makes the shots right here on this channel. You know what? Because I am JTV famous, y'all. Bam, 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 cha, 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 and I'm back, y'all.
Are you speaking English, sir?
Oh, I am speaking English. Are you speaking English? Let me tell you something.
That I'm speaking video, in tongues spent, tonight. After the announcement of our church, Shalawala Bing Bang.
1,000 videos, and that video was horrible. You guys spent $25,000 for 30 seconds. Are you kidding me?
Okay, and did you see the depth of field, sir, in the shots?
Wow. The shots, that's like less than a minute. 30 seconds for 25,000 grand. You guys got pumped.
No, sir. Did you see the production quality? I mean, this wasn't some kind of YouTube special here. This was done
there
with a red
no
cam.
Production.
There was a crew.
I can.
The editing was masterful.
Was that shot in HD? Was that HD?
We had craft services. It was shot in 4K, and we down-converted it to 853 by 480 for the benefit of our JTV viewers. But the master was in 4K. We can show it at IMAX.
Hey, I don't think so. IMAX wouldn't
accept
that. Well,
no, I'm telling you, we can.
I don't think so. It was just horrible. It's like an amateur did that job.
Are you arguing with me about the resolution of the master? How could you possibly? How could you know?
Hey, you know what? I'm a film expert. You know what? And I got my sidekick, and I got my crew right here next to me, and they're saying this is no Lords of the Ring comparison.
And what are your credentials, sir? What are your credentials, other than being an a-hole?
Credentials? I got lots of credentials. You know what? I don't have to prove nothing to you because I'm your Papi 69 and I'm JTV famous.
He's talking that maid language again.
Well, you know what? Let me just
We're
tell
flagged,
you something.
So who cares?
You know what?
Go on.
That girl wants dad's cream of your Papi 69. Uh-huh. That's what she wants. Dad's cream of your Papi
What does
69.
That have to do with the quality of our video, which is stunning, by the way? Depth of field.
Actually, it's not stunning. That is not 3D. 3D is stunning. That's not even 3D.
Do you know what a red cam is, sir? Our video camera is worth more than your house.
Good quality is.
Our red cam is worth more than your house. Our tripod is worth more than your vehicle.
No, you know what? My house
Our tripod is worth more than your El Camino.
You know what? My house is worth more than that. And you had to take donations to film that. That means that you're...
Go ahead, caller. You're on the air.
Hello.
Hi.
This is Pimp Blazer 420.
Hello.
I didn't catch that.
This is Pimp Blazer 420.
Oh, hi. How are you?
I said that was a good commercial.
Oh, thank you very much, caller. I see you are a film enthusiast.
Oh, thank you very much, caller. I see you are.
I think don't listen to the broadcast, caller. Just listen to your Skype. There's a bit of a delay here.
Okay.
Yeah.
I heard you got flagged again.
Yeah, I think that makes number 5.
Yeah. You should put something next time on your channel, say, flag us.
Yeah, flag this. Yeah, I think we're going to put up a graphic next time to honor the achievement.
Yeah.
We're starting to sound like an amusement park here. Yeah. Anyway, what's that? Go ahead, caller. What's on your mind this evening?
I have to disagree with that caller before you. He was kind of a jerk.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, I guess everyone's entitled to their opinion, even if it is uneducated. But we listen to all opinions here.
All right. Well, I'm going to go now. You guys have a good show.
Well, thanks for calling. Now, that's the kind of call we appreciate around here. Okay, we're going to go to our next caller.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you today, sir?
I'm doing very well. How are you?
Oh, I am just fabulous. I had a couple questions.
Okay.
When Richard was doing the lightning strike thing, was that animated or was that real?
No, that was absolutely real.
You're kidding.
It took a number of takes. There were a couple times where when I was operating the camera, I felt the hair stand up on the back of my neck, and I had to crouch down. But we finally got it after 5 takes.
Only
and I think
5?
It was, yeah, 5 takes, and it was quite stunning.
And what was the building that you struck with lightning, quote unquote?
Oh, it was the church.
Why would you strike your own church with lightning?
Oh, because it wasn't a Christian church.
Well, then what kind of church was it?
I don't know. It had some weird writing on the front of it.
Like, in some different language?
I'm not sure. Couldn't really, couldn't make it out, really. But no damage was done to the church. Apparently the the spire was grounded, so everything was okay. Everything was at church, and we are all safe.
Well, I'm glad to hear that you guys are safe.
Oh, thanks. I put my trust in Richard. I knew we were going to be okay.
I would like to make this my official announcement that okay. I am donating $1,000 to the Church of the Neon Bible.
Wow.
Just getting started.
Wow, and I don't want to speak for you, but I'm assuming you challenge all other viewers to the same, to do
yeah.
the same. That's wonderful. That's thank you, caller. Thank you so much.
Where do I go for this donation? Where can I?
JesusChatline.com. Just click donations and just follow the instructions. And we will send you a complimentary Neon Bible and also a copy.
I bet it's like 20 of those.
We're going to send you a copy of Passion of the Christ on, not on Blu-ray, unfortunately, but on optical media.
Wait, is the Passion of the Christ going to be the Neon Bible version?
Well, it's got our director's commentary on it, or not director, but our advisor. We were advisors on the set. Just to get the whipping authentic, to get like the right like wrist action and so forth, and the right amount.
I see.
Yeah, and we will also send a copy of AC/DC's Thunderstruck with that as well.
Isn't that filth music?
Under normal circumstances, yes.
So this is not a normal circumstance.
Exactly. You know what, sir? I think $1,000. Is not a normal circumstance.
Seems pretty normal to me.
Yeah. Well, let's hope so. Let's make it a normal circumstance. Thank you for calling in, and thank you, sir, for your most generous donation.
Hey, I have one more question.
Oh yeah, go ahead.
How big is your dick?
Pardon me?
How big is your dick?
This.
Let's just hang on.
I don't donation or not. I won't condone that, Richard. I won't. I won't.
Who else can meet that?
Who else can meet that donation of $1,000? Is there anybody else who? Okay, so who hasn't had a chance to call in yet? Let's go to this call. Go ahead, caller. You're on the air with the Jesus chat line.
Hi, Stephen. How are you doing?
Oh, I'm doing very well. Who am I speaking? I speak. That was peculiar.
Hold on. Hold on a second. Just a second. Can you hear me?
Yeah. Was that your spy computer acting up?
No, it's, hold on a second. I think it's my buddy messing with the, wire. Hold on. Listen, stop messing with it. Go fuck yourself.
Oh, how do you kill the volume?
Ah,
sir,
sorry.
That made it on the
air.
I hope
he didn't hear that.
That made it on the air. I'd ask if you, do you have
Oh, sorry, I tried to cover the mic.
Do you have that tin can internet there where it's connected by a string?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just kidding. Go ahead.
but yeah, sorry about that. But nice haircut, by the way.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
We can donate money to the JesusChatline.com, right?
Yes, you can.
Sweet.
Not only can you, but it's heavily encouraged.
Oh, definitely. So more about this church, how long is it going to take to build?
We anticipate that it'll be ready by the fall of 2012.
2012?
Mm-hmm. It sounds like maybe you were writing that down, just for your own personal notes.
Put that on your calendar.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Put that on your calendar.
I'm going to be there for the opening.
Oh, that's great. That's great. We're gonna really pack them in. I think, that day. There's a couple wineries we're looking to get shut down in the area, because as you might be aware, there's one or two wineries in Napa Valley, but we anticipate that should be no problem getting those shut down.
In Napa Valley?
Mm-hmm. Is he writing that down?
Okay. No, I'm not writing that down.
Okay, okay. Go on.
But yeah, what else was I going to say? Completely forgot. Old age kicking in, so
oh. Hold on.
What else was I going to say?
Well, do you have any comments
I heard that there was going to be a Muslim chat line coming up. I heard that they're going to be going up against you.
Oh,
I heard
really?
That's the people that's been flagging your channel.
Oh, I'm not aware of that. We welcome all faiths to start a chat line, of course. Everybody has the right to their beliefs, and absolutely, we'd welcome to see any kind of other chat line.
Well, that's going to be good. Hopefully your guys' will be more...
lucrative?
More view. Yeah, that's what I was trying to say.
Oh, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. Okay, well, so are you going to be up to any traveling in the near future?
Definitely. I'm going down to see the Jets play their first game.
Really? Well,
definitely. Sometime in July.
We're thinking, perhaps we'll try and do the same. If it doesn't conflict with any Sharks home games, maybe we'll make the flight up to Canada for that.
Definitely.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you guys have a good night. I'm going to head off now.
Okay. Well, thanks for calling in, sir. We'll talk to you soon.
Yep. Thanks for having me.
Okay. Right on. Well, wasn't that a wonderful call? Oh, we have this call is called Incoming Donation.
Friggin'.
Go ahead.
Hi. I've heard that you've been taking donations for your neon church.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a real nice collection of about 2,000 Mexican slaves out in my fields that I would love to donate to help you build your church.
We're flagged anyway, Richard. Yeah. Oh, go ahead. Okay, 2,000 Mexican slaves. Yeah. Uh huh.
Yes, I would. I just want to donate.
Well, that that would be
out here
wonderful.
And, I mean, if you could send a truck.
Okay. Does it need to be a lowrider?
It probably. That's. I don't know if they would get into any car unless it's not a lowrider.
Okay.
So, but I mean, they've never been anywhere outside of this corner. They don't speak much English either. So I mean.
Here's the question, because money's tight, as you know. There's always construction overruns. Can we pay them in tacos?
Yeah. Well, obvious. I mean, you don't have to pay them at all. They're slaves.
Oh.
I mean, I'm not going to charge you anything. I just want to get them the hell out of here.
Okay. Well. All right. Yeah. Are they healthy slaves?
Oh yeah, they're nice and healthy, and if you want me to send some inside house workers too. I mean, I got some nice ones that work in the house for you too and everything.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, it's sounding better and better here. I think that's really going to help our situation, and I thank you for it. Richard thanks you for
it. All right.
And yes. Amen. 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 Well, thank you, caller. Just go to JesusChatline.com, and there'll be some links there on how to send slaves to us. Just look for the, it's under the Drinkers Go to Hell banner. There's a slave button, and just click that and follow the links.
Oh, yeah, I see it, okay.
Yeah, all right, cool. Well, thank you, caller.
Oh, yeah, I mean, I thank you for taking them off my hands.
No problem. Yeah, we'll put them to work. All right, we're going to move on to our next. Richard, do you want to rock the mic for a bit here? Okay. All right, I'm going to hand it back to Mr. Burnish, but I'd like to thank you for your calls and for joining us this evening and for being here for our announcement and our fifth flagging. I guess you could call it kind of like our like a bit of a Cinco de Mayo here, only it's June. But okay. The next voice you hear will be that of Richard Burnish.
Drop the fucking mic. It's expensive. How many times am I going to tell you that? Hold it.
Richard!
We'll be right back after a quick message.
Don't keep dropping the mic, Steven. It's a $500 microphone. Look, you've got to... Look. Now listen. Every time you wiggle it... You broke it. You fucking broke it.
You know what? Shut up or I'm going to turn that mic sideways and jam it up your a-hole.
Fuck you. Mute the microphone.
Did you mute the microphone?
Yeah.
Hello. Hello, everybody. Sorry about that. We're having some audio issues, I think. I think the microphone is hissing or something. But we got it under control. Okay. I was actually blessing that young lady. That was a prayer. Yeah. Angelina is a good friend of ours. She came down for that photo shoot. And that's like we put up that image just to kind of to test everybody that when you may feel tempted to give in, to just think about baseball, you know. Just so next time you see this image right here, just think about baseball. Works every time. Works every time. Okay.
Can I make a quick statement?
Yes.
I just want to let everybody know in the chat that when you insult Richard Burnish, you are literally insulting Jesus. Now, I just want you to remember that.
Thank you, Stephen. Thank you. That's very nice. Okay. Hello, caller. You're live on the air with Richard Burnish on the Jesus Chatline. I'm going to ask you to keep the language clean. This is a family channel.
You're live on the air with Richard Burnish on the Jesus Chatline.
Caller?
Oh, it's me. Sorry, I didn't know.
Oh, hello.
I just wanted to thank you, Richard, for the anti-homosexual seminar that me and my wife attended a few weeks ago in San Francisco. Yes. After the 1 week intensive anti-homosexuality training and then the 6 week detox in Mendocino County, it was great. Since then, my wife doesn't have those feelings for other women anymore, and I've never been happier. It's the best $40,000 I've ever spent. So I just wanted to give you a deep, heartfelt thanks for all of that.
Well, thank you, and thank you very much for attending. We do try and get the message out that we will cure gaiety. We will cure all acts of gaiety, because you can't get into heaven being a homosexual or a lesbian. So, caller, were you there from the 14th to the 18th, or was this the one that was from the 21st to the 24th?
The 14th to the 18th.
Okay, so that was the one that Stephen and I were both giving.
Yes.
Okay. So how has this been, like, just for the rest of the room who may not be familiar with our services, like these seminars that we give, could you maybe, from being a family man who has gone through this disease and now you have cured it, maybe can you tell a little bit about your experience, how your wife was before and then after? Like, I'd really love for you to share that with the room.
Okay, well, first I want to say that I didn't cure it. You guys did all the work, and I'm so thankful for it.
Thank you.
For those who don't know, it's a couple-of-day intensive seminar where we sit down as couples in a big theater. It was beautiful, the theater that you guys had rented out for us. And we go over all the morality and of homosexuality and how it's so wrong. It really struck home with most of us. After that, they cart away the partners who are suffering from this illness, and there is a few week detox that you take our loved ones on. And I don't know exactly what happens there because I didn't see her for a few weeks.
Yeah.
But when she came back, she was cured. She told me she no longer had those awful feelings that she had before.
Yeah.
And I've never been happier.
There you go, everybody. You heard it first here. The Neon Bible has the power to cure. It has the power to stop you from drinking. It has the power to stop your wife from being a butch lesbian.
Do you want to bring up the AIDS cure with the shock and the holy
water? Well, I'll just come right out and ask this. There's no polite way to ask this, caller, but are you familiar with our work that we do with curing AIDS?
No, I didn't know that you guys were leading researchers in that.
Yes, we are, actually. On JesusChatline.com in the next week or so, we will be selling, it's a two-part kit. What it is, it's a bottle of holy water that has been blessed by myself, and it also comes with it's a form of cup or jock strap. It's equipped with a sponge. Now, what you do is with the Richard Burnish blessed water, you spill it onto the sponge, you insert it into the cup, and you put on, you wear it while you're at work or, while you're pushing your kids on the swing or whatever it is that you do. But what it does is it actually cures, it's been proven to cure AIDS.
I'm a little bit confused. Should people with AIDS be allowed to keep their children? I mean, really, I don't know about that.
Well,
me personally, I wouldn't want...
As long as they're not kissing them on the mouth.
Okay.
Yeah, because if you kiss somebody with AIDS, you do get AIDS. That is a fact. So they have to limit the kissing. So I would just advise, if you are a parent with AIDS and you're in the chat room, don't kiss your children. You'll be doing them a big favor.
All right, this has been very informative. I just want to say God bless and thank you.
Hey, before you go, caller, what did you think of that? Our new video there for our church? Did you see it?
No, I haven't, unfortunately.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm going to roll it for you right now because I'd love for you to see this. It's a fine piece of work. Just hold on the line, and I'm curious to hear, just because you've gone through some of our training, the homosexual detox, take a look at this.
Okay.
God came to Richard and Stephen with a dream of a new house of worship, a house devoted to the one true word, the Neon Bible. Thus began their leap of faith. Through the generous donations of our disciples, Richard and Stephen have purchased holy ground where the Church of the Neon Bible will stand. Brick by brick, they will venture into erecting the greatest man-made structure that man has ever seen. After visiting the grandest churches in the world for inspiration, Richard has taken God's dream to a new level.
So what did you think of that?
I'm speechless. It was amazing. It was beautiful. I'm so grateful to you for all that you've done.
Thank you. Well, you heard it first. Thank you very much, caller. And just to let you know, your donations are still welcome at JesusChatline.com. So, you know, we helped your wife out. Maybe you could help out with a little bit in the donation money.
Certainly when I am out of debt.
Yeah, well, get on that. It's a joke. but, yeah, thank you for calling in and sharing your story with us. And we wish you and your wife many years of straight Christian marriage.
Thank you. Good night.
Please call back. God bless. Amen. What a great call. What a great call. Yeah, just to let everybody know, Richard Burnish does offer, not just Richard Burnish, Steven Chilton and I do have a homosexual detox that we do run and out of the San Francisco area on occasion.
Homosexual detox.
Okay, that's not acceptable. Hello, caller, you're live on the air.
Hello.
Hi there.
Hi. I have a question. Where does Steven Chilton get his haircut?
Well, I believe, is this a joke or are you actually asking? Well, our father Nick Leping actually cuts his hair with. He's very skilled. It's one of those vacuum. Sorry, I crunched myself. It's one of those vacuum cutters that have the shavers built in it, so it kind of sucks your hair while it cuts it.
Sounds pretty sexy.
Yeah, it's called a Floby, and our pastor is very, very good with one. Hello, caller.
Yeah, it's called a Floby.
Okay, that's very loud there. Hello, caller. You're live on the internet. I mean, you're live on Richard Burnish.
Hi. I'm from Tennessee, you know, and I'm a prostitute.
Mm-hmm.
I was wondering if you guys needed any, like, money. I can, like, stay on the streets down there and maybe work the streets and get you guys some money for your chapel.
You know what? No. No, no, no. I'm sick of this. I am right sick of this sinning baloney. We're trying to run an honest show here. We're trying to take calls and help people, and this is the kind of calls that we get.
No, 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 no.
Enough. And you know what, Stephen? Let's just shut it down.
Shut it.
You know what? Good job. You ruined it for everybody tonight.